my concert, when I ask that question, they raise their hands. Just as a word of encouragement to them, I always say, give up. What's so frustrating to me, I'd be walking down the street, when I do this, dude, here we are, I'd be walking down the street, my two friends, Kurt and Phil, we'd see Mark and Jay like three blocks down, and Kurt and Phil would go, hey, look, there's Mark and Jay, and they stick their fingers in their mouth and go, and then way down there, Mark and Jay would go, and they stick their fingers in their mouth and go, actually, it was softer because of the distance. So. It was so frustrating because I couldn't do it. And finally, I must have been 18, I think, probably 18. In fact, I was because I was going to college that summer. I was going to college 500 miles away from home. Nobody knows me there. They don't know I've been suffering with this my whole life. I'm done, and I quit. And I just want you to know, students, I want you to know, take this home with you. I hope this is important to you. I want you to know what a blessing it was in my life when I became a quitter. Talk to your mom and dad about that. They may have some feelings of their own. But I, by the way, I found out, Chris, I could get by just fine without that. I would just go, hey! Great. Here we are. One of the greatest Christian songs in all of American history. Here we go. So I was thinking about it, and I was thinking, well, what would I do if I did try out for that? And I went back and I did a little research, and I looked at, because he was thinking, well, I could do the shadow bit. And I went back and did some research, and I looked at America's Got Talent, I looked at Britain's Got Talent, I looked at Argentina's Got Talent, I looked at the Ukraine has talent. I'm being serious now. All of them have these shows. There are probably more, too, but all those four I looked at. And I looked at season after season after season, and something is consistent through all of them. Somebody always comes on and sings opera, and they sing Puccini. They sing a piece called Nessun Dorma. And it's a very powerful, emotional, musical piece that we don't hear often. But normally it's some frumpy person who comes on. You remember, what was her name from the UK? Susan Boyle came on, you know, and she looked like an old lady, and she stood there and they're thinking, oh, and she was kind of goofy, oh, she's going to be terrible. And then she sang Nessun Dorma and blew people away. And then there were two guys in America's Got Talent, they sang Nessun Dorma and they blew people away. So I got to thinking, what if I did opera? What? It's not funny. So what if I did opera? And then I'm thinking if I could combine opera and shadow, because shadow is so dramatic. It's like taking a color picture and making it black and white, and the black and white is more powerful. That's what shadow does. And so I've never done this for anybody, ever. never done this. I'm telling you the truth. The next session, I'll have to say I did it this morning for the first time. But you are the first ones to ever see this, the powerful beast, Ness and Garth. So, could we have the lights, please? And we can focus in on this. Wouldn't that be great? This is exciting for me. All right. Effective. 3 a.m. I'm in my favorite place. And my wife came in with these empty plastic bottles, and she said, "You did dilute this stuff, didn't you?" That would explain it. Cleanse my digestive system and every other system. I lost computer files that night. Then to make it worse, the instructions from the hospital said, before you come to the hospital for your procedure, be sure that you drink 3,800 milliliters of water. I'm from Minnesota, not Manitoba. I have no idea what a milliliter is. Now, I've never sold drugs. I have no idea what this is. So I'm in my kitchen at 4:30 a.m. with a measuring cup and a bowl and a ruler trying to figure out how many milliliters are in it. What you think about this, students, is 3.8 liters, right? You know what that is. It's 1/2 cup short of a gallon of water. I got to the hospital, the nurse said, "How are you doing, Mr. Stromberg?" I said, "Well, not so well. I just drank a gallon of water. Can you explain why I had to do this?" She said, "Well, we're going to do your analysis. We need to make sure we have a good sample." I said, "How much do you need?" She said, "Well, you need to fill up that, see right, that, you need to fill up that little plastic cup." From here? I hope so, because otherwise this wouldn't be a challenge. And then she went and got the cup, which I thought was disappointing, because I was pretty sure I could have done it. But the whole point is it made me feel old. And also because, honestly, the doctor was maybe 15. Fortunately, he wasn't there by himself. His girlfriend came along. They had their earbuds in during the whole procedure. I didn't mind, though, because they gave me this drug. There must be some adults in the medical profession who know what that sedative is called. Does anybody know? Say it. Verset, that is it. Thank you, man. Verset, that is the name. I always forget the name. The generic name is, sure, I don't mind. Go ahead, do whatever you want. And that was incredible stuff. And that's why I'm wondering what general anesthesia must be like, because I've never experienced it. Or if I have, I do not remember. My buddy Mark, we played basketball together for years. I played basketball, I'm 60 now, but I played basketball up until the time I was 52, 53, and then I quit because I was playing with younger men, the age of my kids, and they're all jumping up and jamming it, and they're all faster than I am and stronger, and I realized they're going to hurt me badly. And I won't be able to get on airplanes anymore, or at least without paying, and so, and do what I do, so I quit. But my friend kept playing this last winter. He popped his Achilles tendon. Hey, students. Do you know what happens when you pop the Achilles tendon? It rolls right up the back. They found it behind his shoulder blade. They had him on a gurney. They're rolling him in to go up, grab it, roll it back down, attach it again. And he said he saw one little drip of anesthesia going to his hand, and he thought to himself, what if it doesn't work on me? And in a panic, he sat right up in the bed, looked the surgeon right in the eye, and said, this stuff better work. And the surgeon said, well, I think it did because we're all done. But we're not all done here at Winterfest. We've just gotten going, and this is going to be a great day. Thank you so much for starting it out well for me, and be blessed. See you later.